Hi again, it's me. Let's talk about leukocytes because this is pretty cool too. We talked about erythrocytes, red cells. Leukocyte means white cell, and that means refers to your white blood cells. You've probably heard white blood cells before, but you probably haven't used the word leukocyte very often. Now, you've probably heard of leukemia. Leukemia comes from this also. It's a blood disease, or it's actually cancer. It's a cancer of the white blood cells. That makes sense now, right? Leuko and leukemia, leukocyte. Makes sense. What we're looking at on the microscope today, though, is again these blood smear slides. They're the blood smear that we took a drop of blood out of our finger, dripped it on a slide, and slushed it, kind of smeared it across. That's why it's called a blood smear. And so we've got all of our blood cells that are inside our bloodstream on this one slide. That's why we see them all grouped together. Okay. So over here on the left, lots and lots of the erythrocytes. There are way more erythrocytes than there are leukocytes. Remember, erythrocytes made up about 44 to 45% of our bloodstream, right? The leukocytes, however, only made up about less than 1%. Very sporadic, kind of spread out everywhere. If you have a lot more leukocytes, you typically have something wrong, like you are fighting off an infection or you have leukemia, unfortunately. But the leukocytes, as you can tell, they stand out like a sore thumb. They don't look like anything else on the slide whatsoever. Plus, our lovely lab technicians have stained them purple. So they stand out because they're number one, they're purple, and number two, they're huge compared to the erythrocytes. So over here on this side, it's pointing out a couple of these white blood cells. Now we have several different types of leukocytes. These I know for a fact are actually called neutrophils. We don't need to get into that yet. We'll learn that later. But over here on this side, you can see a little bit closer, there are three leukocytes on here. And you can see they all have a different shaped nucleus. Okay. This one has a really big round one that takes up almost the entire cell. That's typically a lymphocyte or a monocyte. This one right here has a nucleus that has all kinds of pieces and parts all kind of broke up and stuck together. This is called a neutrophil. Anytime it has a nucleus with lots of parts, it's a neutrophil. And this one is called an eosinophil. And I know this because it has this shaped nucleus here. It's actually kind of shaped like headphones. Again, we'll learn that later. So all you need to do is you need to draw some bloodstream. You're going to throw some erythrocytes in there. And you're also going to draw these really big cells with a weird looking nucleus inside. Okay. The weird looking nucleus is what you're going to name the nucleus. That's pretty easy, right? First thing we name, the nucleus. So draw the cell itself, big old leukocyte, right? And we're going to label the nucleus. And then all of this stuff that's kind of on the outside, it's kind of speckled and it's a lighter pink color. That's all cytoplasm. And this one is actually darker. See how it has more kind of bumps inside of it? This just means it has more proteins floating in it and bigger proteins, so you can see them a little bit better. So this is the cytoplasm. So the nucleus will be inside and the cytoplasm around it. And then on the outside of the cell, whoops, I apologize. I went the wrong way, people. So the outside of every cell is called the cell membrane. So those are the three things we're labeling. Draw a big old leukocyte, label the cell membrane on the outside. Make a strange looking nucleus on the inside. We'll label that nucleus. And everything else on the inside of that cell is going to be labeled the cytoplasm. I know you got this. I'll see you soon. Can't wait to see your drawings.